restart.
Yo,
can you guys?
What happened?
Yeah.
What's up?
I can hear
you. Yeah. Because I was trying to say something.
Oh yeah, you weren't saying anything really.
But yes, Hello? It's working now. Oh, I had to sign in through a different browser.
Ah, yes.
We did look on the Down Manager, the website Downer, and it is, like, D&D Beyond is having, like, a technical error right now. Mm-hmm. So it could also be that.
Yay, it's working!
Yeah,
you guys ready?
Yeah.
I mean, this is what, like, orcs would look like in the desert, I think. I feel like this is a pretty accurate representation.
I guess it just depends on how human you want to make orcs in your world. If you want to make them more like monsters, or you want to make them more like another race of people.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Well, the fact that they can
one of two ways.
Yeah, the fact that you can have half orcs, I feel like you have to make them a people. Otherwise, it's weird.
Fair enough.
Yeah.
Maybe everyone in that are is half orc.
I don't know.
Yeah,
they said they were getting rid of half races.
Really?
Why?
For 1D&D. I don't know if they took that back, but once upon a time they said they were getting rid of half races.
Strange.
No.
I don't see the reason why.
Yeah, once again, because anything is half of anything.
They're thinking that it's like, I don't know,
offensive.
Yeah.
Yeah. Why can't you be half giant, half gnome, huh? Just be an average.
Why not? Where's my giant gnome?
What if you got a really tiny guy with like giant strength?
He's really stout but big.
he got a gnome body, but he got the arms of his giant father.
So he walks on his hands.
He walks on his hands.
That's horrifying.
Right.
Imagine him running at you.
It's better than him getting like the head of his father, you know? Just a little tiny
Wait,
body.
But if he walks with his hands, does that mean he like does stuff with his feet? Like he just
probably
like, his feet and shit. Got opposable toe thumbs.
That's how they evolve.
That's awesome.
Alright.
Yeah.
Alright.
Welcome back, everyone, to
Why
Thoughts...
Why am I at the doctor's office?
Thoughts of Darkness.
You can't have my brain.
Hello!
We are here, gathered here today, because we have four crazy guys. No, I'm kidding. It's because, last time on TOD...
Why is it crazy guy?
Get a load of this guy. last time on Thoughts of Darkness, we... had a pretty good session. We had a lot of things to do. We had a quick dream-ish scenario with Claudette and Neri together about an inaccurate take on their first meeting involving the Misty book. This book is starting to tell about real life events in some kind of code, and we zoomed back to the perspective of the ship and found a Star Moth ship completely haunted.
Oh, yeah.
Last time, all of the lights within the ship, all the visibility, went completely out, and now we take it back here. Neri, are you there, Blucifer?
Yeah, so are we not on the ship anymore? Am I having a hallucination?
So, Bluce.
What?
Right now, you see yourself within a quaint little wooden office atop a red sofa. And you are just sitting, not sitting, but lying. You were lying sideways on this sofa. And you feel like you were paused in mid-conversation.
Not this shit again.
You look around a bit and you see... the same Dr. Hochstapler taking some notes.
Do I remember what I was doing before?
You remember everything that's happened throughout this campaign.
Alright, I'm gonna get up, I'm gonna stomp over to the doctor, and I'm gonna grab him by his lapels and say, what the hell is going on around here? I'm tired of this!
You attempt to do so, but you feel like you merely imagine it, and then you blink again, you're back on the sofa. Paralyzed.
Can I talk?
You can talk, but you cannot move.
Do I sense any kind of magic?
You do not feel any magic of any sort.
What the hell is this? Cut this out! I'd mean to be released. My friends need me back on the ship.
Yes, we were just about to discuss some of that information. You were speaking of some kind of large green ship, and then the lights went out.
And she just staples her, you know, she just puts her lips together and just goes and looks away like, like, I ain't saying shit.
Peculiar. You see the doctor, like, dotting his eyes, writing this weird utensil on this clipboard. And then he asks you a question. Mind if I ask you a personal question, Natalie?
I do.
Well,
I mind a lot.
As a matter of fact.
I was like, you're making it hard to roleplay, damn it.
I can hear you roleplaying, it's fine.
Well then, allow me to rephrase this. I know from your admittance into the hospital that you have a sort of, a memory block. Is that correct?
Maybe I do. Maybe I don't.
Well, if hypothetically you do, are you interested in exploring why you might have this?
What's it to you?
I'm your doctor. It's my job to heal you.
To heal me?
Indeed.
I would like to, what... Do I feel like he's telling the truth? Because right now, Neri is very suspicious of this person.
Insight check with disadvantage.
Damn. Alright, I have a +0 to insight. It wasn't gonna go well anyway.
Who knows? You could land that natty 20.
How'd you get a 0? That's weird.
That's weird.
Anyway, I rolled a 4. Alright.
Okay. You believe that he's being sincere enough, but you don't know to what extent, given everything you know about him so far.
Alright. I would like to remember what happened after I went off in pursuit of my last assignment, as it were. I know it had something to do with my little quirky abilities. I'm not sure I want to tell you my whole life story.
Well, fret not in telling me. All I care about is that you learn more about yourself.
Alright.
Okay.
How about this? You ask me a question. And then I ask you a question.
Very well.
And we can go on like that.
Very well.
Alright.
Who shall start?
I guess you go ahead.
Okay. About how long ago do you feel this event happened to you?
I'll have to... Hold on, DM, how long ago was it that it happened? Like, how long has our group been traveling together?
I'll let you decide that?
I don't know.
What answer do you feel about
frame is so skewed in this game. How long it's been? 20 days? 20 minutes? 20 hours?
Before we got the assignment that started all this shit, how long had we been traveling together? Like a year?
I'll say it's been long enough for you to know each other very comfortably.
So at least a year.
25 years.
25.
A billion years.
When we were fucking infants.
Mm-hmm. Let's say 3 years. Does 3 years sound right?
Okay.
Yeah, I mean, I'm fine with that.
Three days. About 3 years, give or take.
Okay. You see, take his utensil and write the number 3. Alright, thank you so much for that.
Oh, shit.
You got a crossword puzzle you figured out of it? Oh, why'd you write down the number 3?
I'm simply taking notes.
Alright. Alright, it's my turn now, right?
If that's how you want to accomplish this, absolutely.
Okay. And you have to tell the truth.
Okay.
Otherwise, I won't tell the truth.
Okay.
Right? Okay.
How big is your dick?
What do you think is going on here?
By going on here, which in particular are you referring to?
This whole weird me hopping back and forth between stuff happening.
Between stuff happening.
Let me ask a DM question real quick. Mm-hmm. The person, she talked to Dr. Hockstabber or whatever.
Mm-hmm.
On the phone, or was that a different guy? I might have mixed up.
You remember it being his voice.
Okay.
He answers this. Well, clearly your encounter with me at some point led to some mental degradation, and it's my job to figure out at which point this all started.
So are you saying that I knew you before 3 years ago?
Mm-hmm.
Alright, let me ask the DM something. Am I in, like, my human body again?
Yes.
Ah, fuck, I'm in this body again. I need to go back. Ink.
she's just
making straining noises. Like she's trying to climb out. Like she's trying to climb out of her body. And she's like, I don't know how you go from one body to another. Just kind of. Is it doing anything?
You are looking quite blue now. If that's what you intended to do.
It's my normal skin color. Breathe working. I'm gonna start training some more. She will continue to do this if he asks her another question, but she will respond, of course.
Okay, please remember to take a very deep breath at some point.
I'm feeling real floaty. I think it's working.
Because
I'm starting to feel real good. Passes out.
I think I'm doing it.
Pass that shit.
Because my next question for you is, what is your relationship with Miss Saris?
She's my crewmate.
She is your crewmate.
Yeah. I don't remember how she joined us, if she was just looking for work. Or there was some other way that we needed up, so that would be a
Sarah, would
a
you like
Sarah.
To say something about that?
Something about what?
About how you managed or wanted to join this crew of ours.
I don't even remember.
Well, it's not something that happened in the game. It's like...
Yeah. Like, I don't want to make up your backstory, even though I'm being asked a question about your character.
Yeah, I'm asking, like, how would you like to inform Neri here?
Say I was ship-hopping trying to get back to Baldur's Gate, and you guys had put out a notice, you know, needing, like, a healer or ship's doctor, and I joined your crew because of that.
Alright.
Okay.
Neri will answer to that effect. That it was, she was hired on as so, a doctor for the ship.
So she's an asset to you.
I suppose. I mean, we've been through some shit since then. I don't, asset seems like a really cold term.
Fair. Alright, I am prepared for your next question, if you have one.
How do I get out of here?
How do you get out of here? Well, that is actually what I was going to help you with in a moment.
Oh, really? Because I really need to get back to that ship.
Mm-hmm. So, it seems your... What is the proper term? Your trips are mostly self-inflicted. And by that, I mean I can help you reach in and out, if you allow me.
She'll kind of narrow her eyes at him. Can I ask you another question?
I don't see why not.
I tried to get up off this couch and come and grab you by the lapels, but then, like, time rewinded or some shit, and I wound up back on the couch. What happened?
When did that happen?
Like, when I first got here.
I do not remember this.
Of course you don't. Alright. Help me get back to the ship.
Alright. So... First, I want you to close your eyes. I want you to take several deep breaths, as many as you're comfortable with.
She does this.
Now, with your eyes still closed, look up at your own brow line.
Alright.
This is gonna cause...
This kinda hurts.
This is gonna cause your eyes to feel heavier. And then you're going to imagine the rest of the sensation seeping in through the rest of your nerves. Imagine now your whole body getting heavier, sinking into the couch cushion. Your fingers and toes feel tingly, and your heart slows.
They still feel itchy. Is that what we're going for?
Simply continue to breathe. Focus on slowing your heart. One, two, three. Now, at the snap of my fingers, you are going to tell me what happened on that ship.
All right. Now what?
Neri. Sorry, not there. That's my bad. I meant to put you over here. You find yourself inside another room, but at least you recognize this to be the same ship as before. I shall reveal the rest of your guys' locations right now. But Neri, you see that you're in a different room than where you remember being on this ship.
Ah, fuck.
Make sure all of you have control of your tokens. Because that's what you have need of.
Oh yeah, I'm in control of myself now.
Oh yeah.
I'm moving out.
Neri, what would you like to do?
Do I remember that conversation?
All of it.
Neri will kind of stand, look back and forth. Hey, Doc, you still listening?
The room around you is silent as a grave.
I don't like this. Better find the others.
Well.
So, was I with the others and I just vanished in front of them?
Yeah, or was it like a disassociation episode?
Like I just wandered off.
You remember the lights in, like all visible light within this ship becoming extremely dim, and then you feel like you somehow disassociated back into the hospital with the doctor, and now you've reassociated in here.
So I feel like I was dreaming?
Of sorts, yes.
And did I notice she disappear, or did not I notice
Neither of you noticed that Neri wandered off in any way. Only now do you see that she's no longer with you. And Saris, you came a little bit closer throughout the ship, and you feel a sense of uneasiness as you try to locate your friends.
Hey, where'd she go?
Where is Neri?
Alright, Owl, is there a room or anything? I mean, is there a door?
Anywhere.
Right in front of you.
There's a door right in front of you, Saris. Not Saris, Neri. And what did you say, Saris?
I said I don't see my token anywhere on the board.
It's down, you have to scroll.
It's on the bottom.
Make it bigger so that you can see it.
I did scroll, and I'm not seeing it. Okay, yeah, it was off map.
Just in the darkness.
Boss mode activated. Neri crushes, not Neri, Saris crushes the enemies.
So Neri, you said you wanted to locate the others?
Yeah, I'm gonna go out the door.
Okay. You gently open the door. It makes a faint squeak. You see another door left open.
Guys!
I think I hear Neri.
I got lost! Where are you at?
Let's go through this door.
Just about the door.
Plunk. Hello!
Hey, where did you go?
I don't know. I don't remember. I had another weird dream with the doctor in it. And he was asking me questions about this ship.
Yeah, like clipboard.
Yeah, I feel like he might be watching us or something. Just kind of squint her eyes and look around.
Hey, doctor, watch this! And then I, like, shake my ass around.
Oh, watch this. I Fortnite dance. No, I'm kidding. I don't.
Let me break it down for you.
All right, well, glad we found you.
He asked about Cirrus. He said, what's my relationship with her? And I'm like, she's a crewmate. She's, you know, we hired her on, and he was all like, oh, she's an asset to you then. And I'm like, well, that sounds really rude to call her an asset. But anyway, where is she? I'm a little worried she might be in trouble.
That sounds like we might need to find her. Let's go. But I think she's still on the ship, so I think we could just go back to the ship and she should be there, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, let's retrace our steps.
I wanted to loot this ship, but I'm starting to think it might be a little too risky.
Well, once we find her, we should be able to do that. I think.
Alright.
Now, where did we come from?
Downstairs? Yeah.
As they try to navigate Cirrus, what are you doing?
Cirrus!
Cirrus!
This is my first time on the ship, right?
Mm-hmm.
I'm kind of just exploring a little bit, trying to see if anything catches my special eyes.
Your special eyes.
Your special elven eyes.
My brand.
My brand. Here, Cirrus, give me a wisdom saving throw.
Oh god. Hold on, I gotta... Because it's not part of the same freaking browser. Wisdom saving?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, that hurts. 8.
Okay. So, you don't find anything new of sorts. Just, how Neri put it last time, a janitor's closet. But you also feel like you smell something.
Smell the smells.
You feel like something.
I smell with my little smell.
Something cooking.
No, let him cook.
No, I'm sorry.
I'll quit memeing.
I was thinking the same thing.
Yeah, so somebody's gonna be in a pot somewhere cooking. You're just like, oh no, let him cook. He's not ready yet.
Alright,
I'm gonna go towards the smell.
Smell is coming around this corner, this door. Find a stairway and a hallway.
What the fuck was that?
The smell gets stronger the more you progress down this hallway.
Is it coming from down the stairs or down the hallway?
Down the hallway. And the stairs go upward. Okay. Over here, you see a very large table with many, many chairs and some pots and plates next to them. Let me also open up this because you all see that part. Being beckoned by this strange scent, you can hear now the sounds of
of someone cooking something and some humming. What is Sarah's thinking right now?
What am I hearing?
You hear someone, it sounds like a female voice, humming while making something. The smell is very strong.
The ship is empty.
It's a very pleasant aroma. Inviting, even.
Okay. Is this the door to the kitchen, or is it down the hall more?
Right next to you is the door to the kitchen.
Open the kitchen.
Give me another wisdom save.
Didn't do so good the last time. Still didn't. Well, I guess I did good. 20. 30-20.
You open up the room to this kitchen, but you do not see anyone or anything in here.
So I smell something cooking, I hear someone humming like they're cooking something, but there's no one there.
Yeah.
That's not creepy. Is Ghostface gonna pop up out of the fucking cupboards and slash me?
How did you know? You walk around a bit in this kitchen, and you see how... There's some rotten vegetables, some chopped foods, but everything feels scattered. Everything, like, whatever happened here, it was done very chaotically.
What the fuck is that, Javi? Stop it! Freak me out!
It's a ghost!
Alright. Is there anything actually cooking? Or is it just like phantom smell? Like as soon as I walk in the door and see that nobody's there, does the smell just like stop?
You no longer smell it, but you still remember it. And it feels still very... pleasant, nice, like what a parent might cook for their child.
I'm gonna start like opening cabinets and see if there's anything in there that would maybe indicate what it was that I was smelling, like any like ingredients or leftovers put aside.
Sure, investigation check, please.
Not very perceptive, am I?
You open up a cabinet and you see some more food, but you also find something strange. You find a little watch. Something for keeping track of time on your wrist.
Like an old school watch?
Mm-hmm.
Is that kind of out of place for where we're at?
Very. You've never seen this design before or even heard of it.
So something that would be more in place with, like, the Asylum universe.
Probably.
Alright, I'm gonna put it in my pocket so I can show it to the others. Maybe Grin knows something about it. Or maybe it's, something that he can use.
Mm-hmm. You hear an odd sound.
Where is it coming from? Like, is it coming like through the walls? Is it coming from like chimney? Is it down the hall?
You hear it coming from down the hall again.
I step out into the hall, look left and right. It's coming from down this way.
Mm-hmm.
Walk towards the sound. Correct me if I'm wrong, it sounds like somebody in pain.
This sounds like somebody's moaning into a Pringles can.
It's me after I eat Taco Bell.
You hear this sound coming from upstairs.
Okay, I guess I'm going upstairs.
Are we upstairs?
Indeed. Going up the stairs, you find a hallway with the rest of your crewmates.
Oh, hey, Cyrus, we were just looking for you.
Do you guys hear that?
Oh, man, where did you guys come from? Or not you guys, but where did you come from?
I thought I smelled something cooking. I thought I heard someone in the kitchen, but when I went to investigate, there was no one there, and the smell disappeared. But I did find this. And I pull out the watch.
Does anybody recognize it?
And surely we have some kind of timekeeping devices that we've seen before.
Anyone who wants to analyze this thing, give me an investigation check.
I'll do it. If I can, let me on my character.
The only thing you immediately... Oh, nice. That one. Claudette, you know absolutely nothing about this watch.
I don't know. I'm gonna keep it real. I don't know shit about this watch, guys. I've never seen this before.
What's a watch?
Let me take a look. I got an 11.
You know it's designed to look very similar to something you might see on the Asylum.
I think I saw a big one of these, like, on the wall. In the weird place we keep ending up.
Oh, yeah. Where I just had, like, a vision or whatever.
Mm-hmm.
And then he asked me about you, Cyrus. The doctor with the clipboard. So we were like, we better go get Cyrus.
But strange.
Yeah, I thought so.
Has that noise stopped since I found everybody else?
Yes, it has.
Oh yeah, take us to where you said the noise was coming from. I think something weird's going on around here.
Did we hear the noise?
No, you did not.
Okay.
Yeah, Neri just disappeared all of a sudden, and the sounds are out here in the hallway. That something strange is kind of going on.
There's something strange in the neighborhood.
No, are we the Ghostbusters? Are we who are we gonna call? It's us? Are we the guy? I was thinking it in my head, and I was like, "Ghost," but and then I was like, "Yeah." And I was like, "Oh no, we are the Ghostbusters."
What the hell?
We are the Ghostbusters.
We don't have reception out here. We can't call the Ghostbusters.
Also, I'll remind you guys did find a piece of elven chainmail too.
That's true. We did leave here with some treasure.
Wasn't that for Zeris?
Yeah, that heavy armor.
Was that for Zeris? I forgot.
I think we decided. You just remember finding it.
Yeah.
What did we decide on that?
Well, I can't wear it because barbarian.
I can't wear it because I'm a monk.
And I'm a robot. So, it's the saddest it goes.
Is it heavy armor?
It should be just medium armor. But let me check.
Because I don't know if Saris can even do that. Has proficiency in it.
She does have proficiency in light and medium, so it should just be medium armor. Yeah.
There you go.
Because I got my knuckle dusters and like my ring. My strangler. I need to start strangling some more people.
Exactly.
I mean, we fought like brains last time. How do you strangle a brain?
I just have to squeeze them like a Boston cream cupcake or a donut.
Just keep squeezing until the cream comes out.
Yeah.
Jesus Christ.
Maybe it'd be more apt with a jelly donut. Keep squeezing until the jelly comes out.
God, I'm about to bust. I love raspberry filled donuts.
Where's the nut button? I need to slam it.
I have that soundboard on my.
Hey, stop doing the knock one. It freaks me out every time.
There we go.
You guys are starting to hear noises all around you.
We're surrounded. What?
We start hearing noises?
The noises sound like nut.
When you're having a good time and then the ghost busts in.
You think maybe we should check some of these rooms and...
Did y'all hear that?
Oh, we could just leave.
No. I think we can take them.
I mean, what if there's more loot up here? You sure that thing's not cursed?
Sure.
It's probably fine.
I open the door next to Neri.
This one?
Yeah.
Sure, give me a wisdom saving throw.
Wisdom saving throw.
Wisdom saving throw?
Correct.
I can't find my wisdom.
Both of us are just... Or
just him who's opening it.
Just him who's opening it.
But that means there's something attached to it.
I got a 3.
Oh. You opened the door, and I came.
I came.
I
came. Thank you.
There we go. Thank you. One of the coolest villains, but one of my least favorite killers in Dead by Daylight.
You both open the door at the same time, and you see two things stand in front of you, but then they rush past you.
Two things?
Do we see anything? Or did they...
Only Grin and Neri, because they were close, saw it.
The hell was that?
What did they look like?
What is it?
That was like a shadow type person. Sort of like a ghost.
Ghosts don't exist, silly.
Well, I mean, undead definitely exist. So, wouldn't be a stretch. Anything in the rooms that are suspicious or anything like that? Or do we need to look, investigate or something?
What you see in front of you is a very, 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 very dusty room.
Man, someone needs to clean up their shit.
Not sure if someone exists in here anymore.
The things in here not only appear old, but some things also appear smashed.
Something got to here first.
What do you see?
I check to see if there's anything of use or of note.
Sure, give me a perception check.
But it's too scared. I'm not going near that door.
You gotta do something.
You're all the way over there.
I dare you.
I got a 14 that time.
Okay. Through some of the rubble, you find a little piece of paper within the, I'm trying to say collapsed, part of a chest.
What's this? I read it.
I DM to you its contents.
It's all just a game to them. Just a game. Not yet. I'm still in. Alright. Well, the weird fortune. I kind of crumple it up and put it in one of the many little drawers on my body.
He just pauses it up. He's like, I'll save that for later.
Well, not sure what that means. Can't find anything in this room.
Show nothing. Hmm. What about the next room?
Let's take a look. Anybody want to go first?
I'm a little scared. I'll go. I'll open this one.
Kind of get ready to see if I can catch a...
What? What?
I'll see the ghost.
Which are you trying to open, Neri? I mean, Neri. Caught it? This one?
Yeah. Is that a door?
Yeah, right here's the door.
Oh, okay.
So. With saving throw, please.
Okay, okay. I'm so good at wisdom.
The best.
Well, is it gonna roll? Why does it always do this for Claudette?
I am the best at wisdom. No one is better at wisdom than me.
I am the wisest.
I'm the best at wisdom.
I am the wisdom.
I am the weezest.
I am the milkman.
My name is the milkman.
The milk's delicious.
And I'm the wisdom man. Hold on, I'm reloading D&D on Chrome instead of Firefox. See if it'll. Alright, wisdom saving throw. Still doing that. Why does it do that? It won't send my rolls to the.
The roll one.
Yeah.
Yeah. Hold on. I guess you could just like do a 20 on the roll 20 and just add.
Yeah, add my 4. That's so silly.
I like how your Claudette is literally wiser than the actual robot. That's amazing. I got just one.
Alright. It says that the game's not active. That I don't know if that has anything to do with it. Damn, 5 plus 4. 9.
9.
Alright. So Claudette, you gently open the door. This is what you see in this room.
Blood, blood, blood. Well, guys, there's some blood in here. There's a lot of blood in here.
You immediately see a large amount of red viscous slime.
Guys, there's a lot of red slime in here.
Are you sure it's not cherry jam? It looks sort of like cherry jam.
I wouldn't taste it.
I couldn't taste it.
Alright, well, I'm not gonna taste it for you.
yeah,
there's blood looks... and guts. It's just like gross stuff everywhere.
Viscera.
You said it was slime, you said?
Yeah.
This doesn't look like blood. It sort of looks.
Oh, I'm sorry, ignore that.
Claudette. Do you know what this is? This looks like slime.
Let me see that. Okay. Do I roll an investigation? Or do I, like...
Nope. Just tell me what you want to do about the slime.
Is it, like, a slime per se, or is it just slime me?
You aren't sure. It's... You think it's a slime, but you aren't sure exactly what it is.
Easy, dude.
I don't know this one. That's gotta be. I don't see anything.
Underwave.
It doesn't have any smell or anything to it. Like, it just, it's gross and, like, nasty.
It's really red, very gross.
Well, I say that whoever was on this ship is in this room, and this is them. Maybe that's why this place is out here floating.
Well,
but they attacked us.
Maybe when Satis hit the ship...
Didn't that ship attack us?
Yeah. We were being attacked.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, they did. Yeah, it was like somebody was fighting us.
Maybe this is what Satis hit.
I don't know. I'm just like, we were fighting a ship, mm-hmm. but then when we board it, there's no one here.
Is this where this isn't where the seat is that you control it? Have we seen that part?
Nope. You already went past that part. Sarah's destroyed it with her lightning strike.
Okay.
Judging by the location of where we're at and the other rooms, I would say that this is kind of crew quarters.
Yeah. Did they just explode when we hit the ship?
Wait, why is all this red stuff right here? What are these red lines?
I'm not sure this is the crew. This seems not good. I think we should leave.
Alright. Let's head back to our ship.
I say, let's get out of here. We can't get out of here fast. This place is giving me the heebie-jeebies.
It's been creeping me out for a while.
The entire floor becomes littered with this slimy, bloody substance.
Okay, we're getting the fuck out of here.
Oh, God, it's sticky. Oh, it's in my gears. Oh, gross.
This is nasty.
You have something in you. Gross.
Yes, I have, as a matter of fact.
Get... who flung their icon, like, at the bottom of nowhere?
Help! I don't want to get ghost got.
I can't see nothing.
Yeah, it went away.
Yeah, it sucked, doesn't it?
Good luck, roll initiative.
Hell.
Alright. Doesn't Grin have, like, light up eyes that he can use, like, flashlights?
I turn on my light up eyes.
Sure you do. I'm sure you do. Because Grin. Because this is immediately what you see. You're in another room in the ship. With this.
Well, what do we have here? No, seriously, what do we have here? What are you? Oh no, I don't like that at all. Get away from me or I thunder wave you. Yeah, that's what I thought. But...
Get away from me or I thunderclap those cheeks.
Neri, give me a wisdom saving throw. Neri. Give me a wisdom saving throw.
Oh.
I just thought we were waiting, sorry. I was like, oh, wow, that's a pretty long slope.
7.
Oh, dear.
All your visibility, Neri, has been completely... done away with again, but you feel something choking you.
I try to punch it.
You feel the feeling of cloth being wrapped around your body.
It's spiders! It's spiders!
And I'll try to, like, what? What is it?
They're raping me and their women! It's spiders!
Oh, it's always spiders. I hate spiders.
Loth has come for me at last! I cursed her too many times!
I hear you, Neri. It's just the thing that... I think it's one of those things that I run out of the room.
You run out of this room, you find yourself on a different level of the ship, and Neri, you see a black shadowy figure and a bunch of these hammock looking things surrounding you and wrapping themselves around you.
Oh, it's not spiders.
Pod people.
Oh, it's a mummy.
Someone stop her. She was like freaking out, but now she's like low key relieved.
God, thank God it's not spiders.
That's just the cat.
Okay, maybe I should have been spiders then. You know what? It's a hammock full of webbing. Yeah, now it is spiders.
Do I see? Where am I at? Do I see any of this?
You do not see any of this.
Oh.
But Grin, you do.
I charge through the door. Neri!
Hey! The fuck is this guy?
Hey! I'll thunderwave you if you don't go!
You'll hit me too, you dingus!
It's okay, you can take
it. I'll kill
you!
I will just...
Grin is pretty sure Neri will be okay.
I will just... I mean, do we need a roll for initiative?
No. Just tell me what you want to do.
Are we fighting or are we running?
It's a little bit of a wuss, to be honest. I don't know if we need to fight this thing.
Alright. I will pull out my axe and swing it at it. Or whatever I have now. I don't think I have an axe, actually.
What are you trying to hit?
Whatever's wrapping me up.
It's the hammocks.
I thought we were looking at that thing.
No, ignore him right now. You see him,
okay.
But it's the things around her that have moved to wrap around her.
Oh, Neri, you're just in some cloth. I just come over and be like, stop struggling, stop.
All right, undo it.
All right, I just like start helping her.
Okay, you take the help action to free Neri.
That's what I thought.
You see it sink behind the wall, and the hammocks themselves have loosened their grip on you.
What the hell?
Claudette and Saris, you find yourself in other rooms, completely covered in dust.
What the?
Like, these rooms haven't been used in a very long time?
Correct, Among Us.
Oh no, she vented.
I go for the door.
You go for the door in front of you.
Yeah. Can I see stuff? Yeah. Oh, there I am. I'm way up here.
You see the same hallway as before.
I run down the stairs. I'm running. I'm screaming for the homies.
I'm right beside you.
Yeah. We gotta get out of here. We gotta get out of here. We got a skinny doggy.
I wish I could take that as a sound bite.
Gotta feed up.
Alright, we're running back down the stairs.
I'm hollering for Grin and them, like, as we're going.
Okay. Right here. So I need everyone at the same time to give me wisdom saves.
Okay. I'm so wise.
12. Hey, 18.
Okay. Good job, Neri.
How am I saving, bro? Out. What?
I am 12.
Hey.
Need a d20 plus 4.
Grin dies 18. Immediately.
18, you said?
Yeah.
Okay, 18. Saris?
What am I rolling for again?
Wisdom saving throw.
Again?
Yes, a million times. All the time.
We are
they're
so
forever and always.
You think we get better at being wise?
They're trying to make you pee.
No. Okay, you know what? I tried rolling. So I was able to bring up my character sheet on the same browser as Roll 20.
Mm-hmm.
But now when I click to roll, it just brings up a description. It doesn't actually give me.
Yeah, it's,
oh, it's doing the same thing to you.
As well.
Yep.
Yeah.
All right.
Just do it on
a D20.
Yeah, D20 plus whatever your was beside your wisdom save.
Oh, it doesn't matter actually.
Right, yep. No.
Yikes.
Oh no.
That
my saving is plus 5, so it's a 6.
Well, no, because you got a natty 1, which means it's 1. Right?
I know.
Or is that not true? I don't know for sure.
Depends.
Well, she got a nat 1 regardless.
Yeah.
But that's okay. And what was yours, Grin?
It was, hang on, let me look. 12.
All right, very cool. 12. Very cool. So, Neri, after you see Grin help you out of these hammocks, the cloth from it kind of wraps around your face again, and visually, you're obscured, but then you get helped.
Okay.
And this is what you see. Real areas.
What? You're a ghost too? The fuck?
You hear the frantic footsteps of Claudette and Saris coming down the stairs trying to come for you, and you see three black apparitions appear before you.
So we're coming up the stairs and
coming down from
as
the
we
stairs.
Come up the whatever, we're on the stairs, and as we're reaching the next landing, there's two of these things.
Yeah.
Oh.
I'll be like, what'd you do with Grin?
Wait, where'd I go?
I'm like,
Where'd my token go?
I had to remove it for a moment.
How dare you?
But, yeah.
My bones.
So Neri, all of you can talk, but it doesn't seem like Neri can really listen to you.
Oh, okay. Neri. So I'm hallucinating that you guys are the demon looking things too.
Neri. Hello?
What's going on?
Neri's freaking out. Maybe stay back.
What'd you do with Grin, you little demon thing?
What are you talking about? I'm Grin, Neri. Yeah, you guys might want to stay back. I might get pummeled.
What?
Did you
get on top of him?
No, Neri cannot understand Grin's words, but you guys, Claudette, Saris, and Grin can understand each other and Neri.
I will try to, like, pull the apparition or whatever off of Grin.
Okay.
What are you doing? Oh god.
Someone use this spell scroll. I don't, this is a second level. I don't know if he can help.
Oh yeah.
Spell. Is there anything that can help?
I bet you're mad.
Second level.
I succeeded on my, well, I rolled high on my wisdom, but I guess I don't know.
You rolled well, Neri, but the DC was higher for everyone else.
I'm like, Sorry about this.
None of us saved?
You saved, uh-oh. Miri.
I saved? And so they turned into ghosts?
Yes.
Yes. Can I do anything? Like, can you, I can do my normal stuff?
You can do all of your normal things, but it, for some reason, Neri cannot perceive you normally.
Hmm.
What's going on?
Neri's acting funny. And I might need to take her out of commission for, you know, a little bit.
What do you mean by that?
Well, I won't hurt her. Don't worry. And then,
well, I mean, if you need some help restraining, I mean, I'm all game.
What do I feel when I'm trying to, like, pull the cloth off of him?
Bobby?
Or pull the apparition, like...
She grabbed
sorry about
me.
That.
What did she feel?
Sorry about that. I did hear what you said. So, what you feel is... You felt yourself a moment ago... the hammocks were wrapping themselves around you, and you saw a black apparition kind of in the room with you as it was happening. And then you remember Grin trying to help you, but then your vision was obscured. So what do you want to do, Neri, now that you cannot seem to... you don't really know where your friends are, but you're surrounded by three ghosts.
Well, they're not attacking me. Grin! Where are you? Say something!
Right here!
I'm going to use... Let me see, do I have any magic sense left?
Yeah, I don't think you do, actually. You used the last two you had last session.
Yeah, I did, and we haven't rested since then.
Can I try something?
Sure thing.
Am I allowed to try to use... I have a spell called Message. It's an at-will spell.
Okay.
And I... Well, basically, I point my finger at a creature within range and whisper a message. The target, and only the target, hears the message and can reply in a whisper that only you can hear. You can cast this through solid objects. If you're familiar with the target, notice beyond the barrier, magical silence, one foot of stone, 1 inch of metal, blah, blah, blah.
Yeah.
Doesn't have to follow a straight line, etc. Yeah. So I just whisper at Neri, we're right in front of you.
Can I hear this?
You hear a voice very, very hushed saying, we're right in front of you.
Who? Is it you, Doc, again? Quit fucking with us.
Didn't work.
I only know punching. Sorry.
I'm like, let me try one more time. And
but
I,
if you get close, then she might get scared.
I do one more time. Message. It's Grin.
Oh, we can do a lesser spells. Restoration. This is out of character.
That's true.
Okay.
I mean, I don't know if we need it. I don't know, because the condition can be blinded, deaf, and paralyzed, or poisoned. So I don't really know that would help, because she's not really, like... not really like a blindness or like a
you think she's probably affected by something, but you don't think she's necessarily blind. It's what she's seeing something incorrectly, but she's not seeing nothing.
Yeah, like it's an illusion. Hey, yo, what level is dispel magic? Where did it say? Oh, it's not on this one though.
I clicked vortex by accident. Damn it. Get out of here. Out of here. Come on. Sorry, I'm just doing something.
I knock on her head with the Nox bell that opens up. No, I'm kidding.
Damn, I don't really know. Wait, what is this? Oh, it has to be cast on the self, never mind. I was about to say mental barrier, that would work. Self-cast.
How much is
Star
Wars? What is it?
I'll go in here and just kind of start looking for Grin. Or I'll...
So, like, these things are weird.
I think I'll shove my way past what...
Ah! What?
Whatever ghost this is here. Is there a door here?
Mm-hmm. You open the door here.
And I'll
here.
Go in there. I'll go through there. Mm-hmm. Grin! Way to
I
go!
I run after her. And I'm like, that's it! And I cast tongues. It allows me to grant the creature I touch the ability to understand any spoken language it hears.
Okay, you see this shadowy thing trying to touch you with some magic. What
I
do you do, Neri?
I run away.
I'm like, come here! Come here!
running back and forth.
Help me catch her! I just need to touch her!
I don't think this is gonna work. I mean... She doesn't know it's us.
Sarah's got any ideas?
We could try surrounding her.
That's it. And I turn to this table right here, and I just thunder wave it.
Oh my god.
Maybe she'll understand this. Thunder wave. Just thunder wave the table.
What?
Okay.
Okay. Neri, give
do
me.
I...
You see Neri, you see this thing, just start wrecking the furniture even more badly than it was.
Okay, I mean, would I recognize Thunderwave after seeing it and it being memed so many times? Like,
do you think like, Neri is wise enough for that?
I mean, her whole thing is she's a dumb barbarian, but she can kind of sort of sense magic.
So you sense that this ghost is trying to destroy the place.
Well, I wouldn't say for free. I was going to say, like, does that trigger another wisdom saving throw or something? But if not,
no, not this time. If you want, you can give me a wisdom check to see if you can recall that this is somehow communication.
Or
if that
recognize...
doesn't work, I have something else, maybe.
Alright, let's see. Wisdom check. I think that's still plus zero. It almost was on that 20, but it wound up on the 2. So, nope. I will keep... I'll be like, stay back. Where are my friends? And I'll keep looking for them.
Okay, we can cast Magic Mouth as a second level spell, and... It says we can implant a message within an object in range, a message that is uttered when a trigger condition is met, aka you could just be like, speak this in the next second. Choose an object that you can see and that isn't being worn or carried. Speak the message has to be 25 words or less, though it can be delivered over as long as 10 minutes, so you can take as long as you need. And then it says, when that circumstance occurs, a magic mouth appears on the object and recites the message in your voice and at the same volume you spoke. If the object has a mouth, it'll use that mouth. When you cast a spell, you can have the spell end after it delivers this message, or it can remain and repeat this message whenever the trigger occurs. So 30 feet.
So what are you trying
to
do with this
spell?
For
example, it says you could instruct the mouth to speak when any creature moves within 30 feet of the object, or when a silver bell rings within feet, basically. So we can cast a magic mouth on something around here, and it'll a message in our 25 words or less, and it'll keep repeating for as long as we want it.
Okay, and what are you gonna do that on?
I can't I don't know if I can. Can I cast? Like, is that even...
I mean, sure.
Because I'm not really a spellcaster, but I was gonna have maybe Grin do it. But I don't know. We gotta find something in the room that
a
magic mouth
can
appear on. Yeah, it's that 1 second level spell scroll that you gave me at like the beginning of the game, and I was like, I don't know what I'm gonna do with this. But it's just, you said any second level spell, you know, within reason. So
okay.
I figured this one's pretty silly enough. But apparently it's, you get it either by playing an artificer, a bard, or a wizard. So those are the ones who have access to these spells.
Okay, so then I'll say that you can give this scroll of magic mouthing, as weird as that sounds, to
magic
Grin.
Use this to cast a message. I don't know if she'll understand us or if it will come out as the other, as the illusion, but I mean, it's worth a try. 25 words or less, and you could set it to trigger every time she goes near it, or we go near her, or whatever. Is there, what is in the room? Is there, like...
A lot of smashed furniture.
I mean, I guess it's metagaming, but I feel like, I mean, I got messaged. I got the message, it didn't sound like you guys. So she got weirded out. So I don't know if this is gonna be better.
Yeah, like, I don't know if it's gonna be our voices, or if it's gonna come out like the message.
Well, we
How about this?
The
Try
better.
Describing what you want it to sound like.
I want it to sound like Grin.
Okay.
And then I wanted to just say, attention, Neri, you are running away from Grin, Ceres, and Claudette. Please come back to us.
This is a hallucination.
This is not a hallucination.
I'm assuming that's 25 words or less, give or take.
Watch me thunderwave this table again.
Okay, and what are you casting this message thing on?
The wall in front of her.
The wall, okay.
Yeah,
Neri,
so a magic mouth will pop
Neri,
out.
Neri, just... you see like a just a wooden, sharp, almost toothy piece of wood from the wall kind of sprout. And then it speaks what Coma and Grin just said.
What the fuck? I will pause. I don't know if she would believe that this is something weird.
Watch me thunderwave that table again.
We're all just standing there like, we're like, do you think she... Do you think she got it? You think...
Neri, come on.
Is she gonna kill us?
Come on, Neri. Come on, Neri. Come on, Neri.
I'm trying to think. Of something.
I say no and run away now.
No. Give me a second.
TikTok.
Sorry, I'm trying to think of a question to ask. All right. If you want to use is Claudette, what did we find on my ship when we first met?
Oh, it was the book. Do I have the book?
You do not have the book, but you know the answer.
I mean, I can't hear y'all, but I guess you could, like, try
you're
writing
hearing,
it
out or
something.
You're hearing the... They somehow casted magic... mouth on the wall, and you're hearing and seeing the mouth talk.
Yeah, I'm gonna move away from that because that's really weird.
I just cast the message of the cantrip, so I just cast it again in order to whisper to her.
Here, let me draw it.
Book.
Is that?
That's the,
is that
that's
the wall?
The mouth. Yeah, that's the,
okay.
That's the wall.
Book.
Someone hold up a book. I grab a book.
So do I hear the word book?
You hear the word book speak, yes.
Okay. What the fuck is going on? You all look like fiends.
Oh, that's what's happening. She sees us. She's hallucinating.
Maybe she's stuck in the... Maybe she's stuck. Half asleep, half awake.
Well, I better thunderwave the table so she believes that.
I better keep destroying things.
I say we try
things.
To get out of here. Tell her we gotta find an exit.
I think we need to find an exit. Exit.
Alright.
Okay. And I'll rule it that with the amount of words total you said, that is the last thing you know you can say.
Oh, I whisper.
Mm-hmm. You whisper it? Oh, you're using the spell whisper?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Alright. You hear, I think we need to find a way out of this place.
Ah, I'm so glad that my accent carries over in the whisper. She'll definitely know it's me.
Okay.
excited to do it. Have we gotten through to you?
I mean,
have
should
we
I
gotten through?
Like, I'm trying to be fair in terms of like I know it's you guys, me, Bonnie, but I'm trying to think what Neri would do, and I think, and I don't want to be too annoying with it, but I also don't want to be like, oh, of course it's you guys. I'm so smart.
Okay, yeah.
Nah, I get it.
I'm trying to find the cheapest ways around.
Wait, hold up.
What is that?
Hold up.
Stupid game won't let me tug it.
Do we see that?
You all, the three of you, not Neri, see a flying sword come spawn, go around a door, and then take aim at Neri.
Guys, I think we need to stop that.
What is that?
I kind of start heading towards Neri.
Yeah, I'm trying to.
Neri will be like, keep like 5 feet from me. This is really weird. I still don't 100% trust that you're one of y'all. You all look the same. I can't tell who it's supposed to be. I'm guessing you got turned into these fiends and we need to turn you back.
I make a mad dash at Neri and touch her with tongues, the spell.
Yeah!
Now she can understand us, right?
I will try to dodge. I'll be like, no, don't touch me.
Okay, Grin, let me look up your unarmed strike.
Unarmed strike?
Attack, unarmed, it is a plus 4. Give me a d20 plus 4, dude.
Beats my AC.
Yes.
D20 plus 4, I don't remember how to do d20s. There it is. Roll. Roll away! 17 plus 4, 21.
Does that beat yours?
It beats my AC.
Okay, so 21. you see this shadowy thing cast some kind of melee magic spell on you. What do you want to do about it, Grin?
The melee magic shadow? What? You mean Neri, right?
Yeah, Neri. Yeah, Grin casted it on Neri. What do you want to do about it?
What does tongues do?
Tongues allows you to understand us again, because it allows you to understand any spoken language.
I don't hear you speaking at all.
Oh, now, okay, cool. So now I talk, right? Neri, there's a sword behind you!
do I hear him? Wait, hold on.
Yes, you do. What? You do hear him. And also, I'm gonna do this now.
It came. It slashed through all of us.
Sorry, I accidentally hit play on my phone when I was moving it. Grin. I had to fix that. All right.
Grin caught it. I'm gonna see who I.
Nah, yeah, nah. He don't get me. He don't get me, cause I. Hold on, I got a bonus. I got a reaction over. let me read this.
Waste
three
spell slots
for any fucking
chat on that like a chicken.
not that, damn it. Nah, patient defense, that's not a reaction. It's been when key put to dodge action as a bonus action.
Oh, I gotta actually do the spell slot.
Where's the... Oh, there.
Thunderwave, yes. That's the one. There we go.
Yes, that's the one.
Sorry, I was trying to make sure that I did my spell slots the right way.
Neri. Alright. I'm just gonna roll a 3d20 now.
3d20? Oh my god.
3d.
Well, just to see if it hits our AC.
Alright, I got a 19, 8, and 6.
Jeez, that first one.
Okay, Neri, I don't think. Yes, it does, actually. Neri, 19 beats yours. This one is Grin, and the other was Claudette.
So 8 and 6. The other people besides Neri do not get hit, but Neri, you take 1d8 damage from this sword, and that's 4.
I assume I see the sword.
You see the sword fly towards you, but once you do, it does. It flies.
What?
You turned around to look at the sword, and then as soon as you saw it, it flew.
Oh, okay. And it hit me for 1d... Yes. Well, how much damage?
4.
4.
4, okay. Only a flesh wound.
It's just a flesh wound.
Unfortunately, it's poison, actually.
The fuck is that? We ever heard of a flying magic sword before?
That's a ghost! That's probably a ghost! Grin's all freaking out because he just almost got slashed.
Right.
Finally, I understand fighting. I don't speak all that gobbledygook, but I speak these hands.
You speak these hands?
Absolutely.
Grab that sword!
Which one's me?
It's
this one I can move. Okay.
Oh, no.
I mean, you can have, well.
Have the what?
I was gonna tell Javi, you can have it be their icon, and I just know that I still see them as ghosts, but.
Nah.
Whichever. Alright.
Now we're ghosts still, you can just hear us.
Ooh,
we're ghosts, Neri!
Wait, are we officially in combat?
Why did
no.
you let us die? We're haunting you now.
Yeah, and actually, Neri, a lot of furniture from the stuff that's been smashed is flying its way towards you now.
Good grief. What is this fucking nonsense? Where's the exit? Where is the exit? Is it the stairs?
You remember back the way you came.
Alright, I'm gonna sprint that way.
I charge. Can I charge? Or am I getting arrowed to death?
Charged?
I'll try to smack the sword out of the way with my axe. And move on through.
Okay.
Back to the ship!
I'm running! Reveal area.
Back to the future.
Reveal area. You see this large thing place again?
I'll look back to see if y'all are following me.
Ooh.
Are ya, guys?
I... see if I can grab the sword.
I want to grab it on your way out.
Okay, it's gonna try to attack you now.
I ain't touching that weird thing.
Yeah, I got a 3 to hit you. It does not hit you, but it like kind of swipes at your hand as you reach for it.
I bat it out of the way. Never mind, you're not worth the trouble.
Ow.
I'll get you one day, you ghost sword. I sprint away as well.
Okay. Alright. Alright, so... all of you know that this way is the exit.
Yes, of course I do.
This right here, the ship's butthole, is the exit.
Alright, I will continue that way.
Yay.
Yarg.
Not back me, I go back. Ship. I'm just going.
Yeah. Wow.
She's being right. Flanked by 3 ghost guards.
Alright, now get her.
Get her.
Everybody beat
kill
her up.
Neri.
Beat her up.
Kill Neri.
Stab her in the heart.
Kill John Lennon.
I know what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna go off and have my own solo adventure.
I'm gonna go smoke weed and play Burnout Out Revenge for the PS2. Okay.
I'm gonna be soon.
So, yeah, all of you try to get out of the ship.
Yeah.
All right. So, I will say all of you make it to right here, and bam. So all of you make it outside the ship, and this also happens.
Violence.
It explodes.
Anal explosion, sorry.
Whoa.
tries to steal Ghost Sword. Ghost Sword doesn't want to be stolen. Man, never mind.
Okay. Valk. As the rest of your comrades successfully make it out, you do hear this, at least. We missed you.
Okay, that's not creepy.
You remember way back a long time ago, you heard this sound. The sound that prompted you onto the ship in the first place.
Do I hear where it's coming from?
You hear it coming from this, from the another part of the ship, and then you also hear another voice trying to calm it down. Shh, shh, shh. Keep quiet.
Probably against her better judgment, she's gonna go and see if she can. Because if there's somebody on this ship that needs help, to help them.
Okay.
Do any of us see Sarah's turn away?
No, you do not. But for one moment, allow me do something here. I'm gonna do something here.
Someone stop him.
Someone stop.
He's pulling his cock out.
He's doing it.
No.
He's pulling his cock out.
He's pulling his cock out.
Wrong thing. Reveal. Around the center of the storage container of the ship, you notice a hole in the floorboard.
Okay. Dry up the floorboard.
You pry open the floorboard, and you notice a journal. This little tiny red journal that looks ornate enough as if someone wealthy owned it.
Pick it up.
Let me DM you the contents. I might have to do it in pieces. So it. Oh, yeah, I certainly do have to do it in pieces. So you open this little journal up, and you feel a strong sense that whatever was crying, it didn't come from this journal, but you feel like they're linked.
following this instinct. You open it and are presented with some passages. Would you like to read or no?
Day one, my journal. I start writing in you today to keep better track of my thoughts. I am Murtessa Okoye, mother, sister, and businesswoman. All blueprints and ship components that my husband makes. Yes, yes, this is me. I have felt a lot of things as of late, namely an untold amount of bliss. I have a second child now, a young girl with eyes that melt your soul and a warmth only a mother could feel. She is everything to me. But for some reason, I often feel too guilty to be by her side. I am often distracted. I have to help keep our business afloat, for her sake. For my son, her main's sake. For my sister's sake, too. I feel wrong. A mother's focus should be on her children, but I feel so pulled away. Day 8. My market sales have been less than desirable as of late. All across the galaxy, those that have been sold Keltor's star moth ship designs have been issuing complaints. Our magic does not seem to be pushing the ships anymore. I can't place why, but I feel it too occasionally. If this dampening aura impacts my body and spirit, I cannot explain how or why this is, but it's my job to provide a steady stream of desirable ship components. So if I must understand where this field, this anti-magic, originates, I surely will, I hope.
A few more pages, you turn.
Day 95. For the past several days, I have noticed a small ship stalking us. It just waits idly before drifting away. Odd. Hermaine says how it could be a client, but my recent reviewers have been less than kind to us. It has been months since this dampening anti-magic has hit our ship products. Even now, our ship sometimes struggles to sail. I have received a number of rude letters and even vague threats from those I used to do excellent business with. Keltor only has one theory. Either it's a mirage or a warning. Day 100. This ship will not stop tailing us. A lamprey ship always following less than a few kilometers away. Serene has went to investigate it, but hasn't returned in hours. I do not know what to do. It has made no attempts to contact us or attack. It just watches. Why?
Turning it for one final time, this last page feels very hastily scribbled.
Day 100,000. I don't believe it's safe to keep Leah in her crib anymore. It has officially been a full day since Serene tried to make contact with the ship. Keltor has gone restless and seeks to challenge it. Hermaine has started to agree. Very well. We must remain united. I refuse to be backed into a corner like some animal. My dear daughter, I am sorry for the series of events that have transpired. I hope my anxieties are fooling me, but just in case they are not, I want to write you something. We're still so young. Just in case this somehow does prove to be too much for us, I hope you can forgive us for letting you down. I pray whoever they are on that vessel will not find you, or at least will show mercy. Please, if you find this book, do not come find us. Live your life, and live far away from us if need be. Be hopeful, be ambitious, be strong, just as I have been for you. We love you. I love you, my daughter. Stop populating ghosts on the ship.
You notice a few specters out the corner of your eye. They don't seem to do anything. They just fade.
Like, this ship, like, caught in, like, some sort of, like, temporal flux or something.
Aren't all hauntings?
I mean,
at least I think so.
Talking about, like, a lamprey ship tailing them. That wasn't us, was it?
Not to your own memory. No.
I don't recognize the ship, do I? I know I have a little bit of a memory block.
You know for damn certain, Neri, that something happened here.
Damn.
But that's it.
It's an American ship. It's from Cleveland, Ohio.
Yeah, that's right.
Yeah.
Also, I will take your attention back to the last few sentences, Saris. It seems like you skimmed over it, but there is a misspelling. And I left it there on purpose.
Last entry?
Mm-hmm. Here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. The 9th sentence.
I'm glad we all made it to the end of this Disney movie, guys.
I am sorry for the series. It says, I am sorry for the Saris. Wait a minute. Am I the daughter?
I thought that's what was going on.
What do you choose to do now?
Do I still hear crying baby?
This whole place feels silent, as if some kind of presence has left.
I'm gonna hold the journal to my chest, take one final look around, and then leave the ship.
If this ship was akin to a haunted house before, it now feels like a tombstone.
No more spectral activity.
You exit this ship humbly, with this thing clasped to your chest.
Neri is just like jumping next to the chair thing and be like, let's go, let's go, let's go. Neri, where'd you go?
What?
Thunderwave! No.
That's a great place to end session.
Thunderwave doesn't solve everything.
It's like I'm gonna stand there. This house is clean.
Yeah.
What's really creepy is we all have ghosts inside of our bodies. Inhabiting them. Whoa.
Yeah, that is really scary.
Yeah,
like, really, really scary.
Out, but you have a
and skeletons.
Skeletons. Scary, slimy monsters.
My nurse maid used to say that if I had an itch, it was my skeleton trying to hatch out of my body.
Oh, God.
All right. So that was session 15.
Number 15.
Number 15.
Oh, but lettuce.
Stop it now.
Watching you out of hang.
Next session is in 2 weeks, and we resume your regularly scheduled program.
Wait, 2 weeks, so July 6th?
It'd be July 7th.
7th, okay.
July 7th, heaven.
With my new job, I'm starting like a work from home job. Training is starting July 16th for me, but my first 90 days I'm in a probationary period, so I can't miss any days. So I don't know what my schedule is going to be looking like around the 16th. Like we'll be able to do the 7th, no, because I don't start until after, but I don't know what my schedule is going to look like because it's a work from home like call center job.
Well, how many more sessions do you figure we have in this game, honey?
Oh, a billion.
Oh, okay, never mind then.
Like it might take us like the rest of this year.
Oh shit. I thought this was a shorty.
Yeah, I was wrong.
Because Avi keeps adding stuff onto it.
I was wrong. I was wrong.
Why is he wrong?
Let me try to guess. Also, I forgot to say this. You all level up as well.
Ooh.
And you're on session 15, number 15. It might.
Number
15. I would say roughly you guys got about maybe 10 more sessions to go. So like the rest of this year.
Okay.
Gotcha. Yeah, if we stay on like the schedule.
Yeah.
How do I level?
We're level 9.
Go hit the anvil. And then go to go back to class, and then there's a drop down, and then
up. What the fuck? At 9th level, I gain the ability to move along vertical surfaces and across liquids turn without falling.
We're level 9?
I'm level 9.
Level 8.
Yeah, she leveled up randomly because she won a coin toss another session ago.
See, sometimes I forget to level my character up. And then I'm like, what?
No, remember back in like the shuttle hunt when I said
I remember now.
Claudette's body. She leveled up from that. So she was a level higher than everyone else.
Oh, shit.
And now she still is.
Level 9. Nice. Don't worry, I'll skip the pap anybody.
Number 9.
Number 15. How did you guys feel about the session?
It's good.
We're good.
I'm pretty sure I know what's going on, and I'm sad.
Who's dying?
I'm dying.
Not allowed. Grin is the only one that's going to live forever.
Yeah, true. I'm a robot.
A robot.
Me die. I'll just rebuild
Plasmoids
myself.
Plasmoids technically don't have a death, so unless someone kills her or she dries out.
So is Ceres, actually.
Yeah.
My brain is in the cloud. So
things that are native to the astral plane, aka space, don't physically age after a certain point.
Oh, interesting. And robots don't either.
Also, Ceres, Val.
Yeah.
You take a look at the massive time skip on the journals I sent you. The days?
Yeah, it went from like day 100 to day 100,000.
Oh my god. What the fuck?
Let me ask you something. How old would you say Ceres is, do you feel?
I don't know. Maybe like mid-30s?
700,000?
Or whatever that is for elves.
Old.
She's a billion years old. Okay.
She's 69.
Hell yeah. Okay, well, yeah, there's a significant time skip there for some reason. I wonder if it means something. It does. And next session, we're going to resume the final part of this shuttle hunt, and then we can be done with this
boat ship.
This chapter, like this.
Oh.
And then we can move on, and then things will start making sense, and I will also, you know, yeah. Yeah, yeah. Alright, I got nothing else planned for the rest of the night, so does anyone want to play games?
I'm gonna go see if... I told a friend of mine I'd play Overwatch with her, but if she decided to go to bed... then I will come play games.
Yeah! Okay.
Yeah!
Alright, right. I'm glad you guys liked my haunted ship, because I liked making it. I did feel like I kind of confused you guys at some points, and I apologize for that.
Yeah, I'd be mad confused. But, I mean, it plays into the character, because, I mean, I don't know what's going on.
I might be a group. Robot, but I'm not smart.
I'm not smart. What I kind of figured might happen from this scenario was that Neri might like lash out and rage because she just thinks ghosts are hunting her. But you guys got creative with it and convinced her, so good job.
Yeah, let's go. The message really came in handy though, like your message spell.
Yeah.
In hindsight, a talking wall was a little terrifying.
Yeah.
Yeah. I was like, it'd be weird, bro. I feel like Mary's.
It's not, like, not haunted.
That's, well, that's not a haunted activity. That's not paranormal.
Ghosts.
It's beautiful. I love ghosts so damn much.
You turned us into ghosts.
Also, yeah, so, Valk, if you want to hold on to that elven chainmail for armor, you absolutely can. It's for you, if you want it. And that watch I gave you that you showed everyone else, you can also add it to your inventory, but once you, it's a watch of wild magic.
Okay.
Watch of wild magic.
So you can keep it for yourself or give it to someone else if you want. Yeah, it's basically a little wristwatch that you can set the time on, and the time will make a different magical thing happen. Yeah, I thought of it when I was like smoking weed and playing Burnout Revenge for the PS2.
Experimenting with diet soda.
All right, well, I am excited to play more games with y'all. I'm going to jump in another server now.
All right, which one?
Valks.
Okay.
Heck.
Oh, yeah. I'm muted. I have some stuff I can do. I gotta right. do, but
yeah,
bye,
figured.
You have a good...
good night, Coma. Thank you for playing.
Good night.
Of course.
Good night.
Good night.